for Allah Almighty and weak nation for Rasulullah, weak ummah for Rasulullah. However, how much, even billions and billions of dhikr we do, nothing. Not Allah Almighty is going to be increased. Or whatever we do, nothing will benefit Allah Almighty. Allah Almighty is benefiting everyone. Allah Almighty is rewarding everyone. Allah Almighty doesn't expect anything from anyone. Allah Almighty is the God whom in His hand all His creation created them, Allah Almighty. Why? Only Allah Almighty, because He loved them. He said, I love you, I created you. My love to you before your love to me, Allah Almighty said. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, my love to you before your love to me. And for this, how much the one try to approach to Allah Almighty, never he will be approaching by worshipping, never he will be approaching by all kind of facing the Qibla and night and day, praying and worshipping. No one worship Allah Almighty and pray and make sujood to Allah Almighty like Shaitan, like Iblis, like devil, like Satan. He was the most one worshipper to Allah Almighty. And at the end, what happened to him? He was cursed by Allah Almighty. And all his worshipping cursed, and Allah beat him out. He told him, I am not in need for all your worshipping. I need Allah Almighty, what he needs from the one. Allah Almighty needs from the one to be humble, to be his heart open so widely to carry on and obtain all the creation of Allah Almighty, to obtain all human beings, to obtain everyone, bad one or good one, to be all of them entering into his heart, to clean them, and to pray for them for the best. And Allah, if they are bad, will change them to goodness. And if they are good, Allah will give them more and more goodness. Allah like the one whom always thinking how to help the people of Allah Almighty. Why Allah Almighty sending prophets and seals of prophets to help His people, to make His people to come to take them out of the darkness of kufr to the light of faith, of Iman, to bring them to Him, Allah Almighty. Allah Almighty always looking at the heart of everyone. Allah Almighty not looking at what you are doing. Allah doesn't care for all you're doing. If you do your best to please Allah Almighty, then make your heart to be pleasing everyone and humble to everyone. Make your face and your heart to be one. Don't make yourself to have two or three faces or four faces, or your heart's not the same as your face. This is the attributes of hypocrisy, of hypocrisy. And for this, be careful that Allah Almighty in day of judgment, even when the one is passing away from this life, Allah will be questioning him according how his heart was toward his creation. He was humble enough, he was loving everyone, he doesn't carry any hatred or enmity to anyone. Allah Almighty will be then make him to be in neighborhood to Allah Almighty and to Rasulullah in the highest paradises, in Firdaus al-A'la. And the one who has worshipping so huge, more heavier than heavens and earths, and his heart is full with hatred to everyone, enmity to everyone, and full with proudness and with all means of bad intention, niyyah toward the other, Allah Almighty will curse all his worshipping. He will erase it, Allah Almighty. And he will say, O malaika of hell, O Jahannam, come and take him to Jahannam. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, لا يدخل الجنة من وجد مثقال ذرة من كبر في قلبه. Never a one who Allah Almighty finds tiniest and less than of an atom of proudness in his heart. نفر من أكبر تجمع. If anyone has smallest and tinier than atom, one atom of proudness in his heart, never will enter to Jannah. He will be washed and be clean in Jahannam. Paradises cannot carry one who has a proudness. Paradises cannot carry anyone who has disobeying Allah Almighty. Paradises cannot carry anyone who has hatred or enmity in his heart to anyone of the creation of Allah Almighty. And for this, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and the Sahaba, they asked him, who is the Muslim, Ya Rasulullah? They were expecting that Rasulullah would say, the one who worships, the one who faith the Kaaba, and all the praying, and how much doing goodness to please Allah Almighty by worshipping. What he told them, oh my Sahaba, the Muslim, the real Muslim, he didn't say the real mu'min. The real mu'min is something else. Ihsan is also something totally else. The Muslim, he said, the Muslim is the one whom everyone of a human being, origin or malaika, all creation, especially human being, in humanity, the one whom everyone is saved from his tongue and from his hand, he is the Muslim. Everyone, he didn't say to be saved, the mu'min or the Muslim from you, but everyone of children of Adam alayhi salam, of a human being, male or female, the ones whom you will be saved from your tongue, but by backbiting, enmity, scolding, insulting, and doing all the worst thing to the one, and sharpening their tongue to be attacking everyone, and not happy with anyone. And their heart is totally work that make their hand, if they can kill the one, or if they can beat the one, or slap the one, they will do it, they don't care. And for this Rasulullah, he say, the Muslim whom Allah loves and Rasulullah and enter to Jannah, whom everyone of children of Adam alayhi salam will be saved from his tongue and from his hand. Mean that his heart now is well washed by Allah Almighty and well clean, and Allah Almighty make his heart like the Kaaba of Allah Almighty, house of Allah Almighty. This is the Muslim. How about the Iman? How about the Mu'min? Who is the Mu'min? Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, the Mu'min whom in all his life, in every moment of his life, anything in front of him coming, which is halal, he will do, which is haram, he will leave. The one who obey Allah Almighty and disobey Shaytan, the one who always seeing Allah Almighty facing him, the one who is seeing Allah Almighty always looking at him, the one who see Allah Almighty always present with him. If you want to talk, Allah is hearing me. The one who see the faces of people facing him, the face of Allah Almighty. The one who see the eyes of people looking at him, for all creation, the eyes of Allah Almighty. The ears listening to him, the ears of Allah Almighty. The one who see like this, then he will be start to put the first foot in the way of Iman. And the first way of Iman, when you put your foot in the first stage of Iman, the spirituality of Rasulullah will appear for you. Vision you will have. And then you will say, Ashadu an la ilaha illallah, wa ashadu anna Muhammadan Rasulullah, in front of Rasulullah, of his reality. And he will say, I am accepting you as a nation, Ummah for me, as a spiritual Sahaba for me. Like this, the Iman. About Ihsan is much more higher than all this. The Ihsan is to worship Allah Almighty, is to be all the time with Allah Almighty, making no existence for yourself at all, only the existence of Allah Almighty. No more you have a humanity. You will be finishing your humanity and making the lights of Allah Almighty, from which you are created, to be worshipping and presence all the time with the divine presence of Allah Almighty. As Sayyidina Ali radiallahu anhu wa karram Allah wajhah, he said, Rasulullah made us to read that never we make sujood to an unseen God. And for this Rasulullah, he said in the hadith, the ihsan is to worship Allah Almighty as if you are seeing him. Because if you are not seeing him, he is seeing you. And there will come a time that you will see Allah Almighty as well as he is seeing you. Allah Almighty, there is no veil between Allah Almighty and all of us. While there is 80,000 veil between us and Allah Almighty. You must take them, veil by veil, one by one, to clean all of them, to clean yourself from them. No more to have egoistic body in you. No more to have satanic body in you. No more to have any kind of relationship with Satan, with Iblis, with devil in you, to be only a divinely godly one, as Allah Almighty saying, obey me, my servant, I will make you a godly one, divinely one. If you say to something, be it will be. أَطَعْنِي عَبْدِي أَجْعَلُكَ رَبَّانِيًا إِذَا قُلْتَ لِشَيْءٍ فَيَقُولُ. And to obey Allah Almighty means you are going to leave everything else than Allah Almighty and to be all the time facing Allah Almighty. And this is very difficult. And for this only the Imams and chosen one of the Sahaba, they reach that maqam. Not all of them. While all the Sahaba, they reach very high maqam, that all of them like stars, Rasulullah make them. And he say, my companion like stars, by anyone you guide yourself, you will be well guided. Even though there is Imams for the Sahaba, whom they reach to be annihilating in Allah Almighty. Die before you die, finishing their humanity totally, and blessed by the divine God, the reality of them from Allah Almighty, whom saying the reality of every one of you, the divine reality of every one of you in my hand. Come and all returning to me to take this reality. The one who will struggle in this life to reach and to perfect and purify his spirituality, his reality, to reach, to take his reality from Allah Almighty, he will see all the doors of Allah Almighty open for them. And the one who is neglecting Allah Almighty, putting Allah Almighty on his bed and Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, then all doors of Allah Almighty are closed for him. And for this, the one must be very careful that Allah Almighty, how much will give you age at the end you are going to die. Whatever you live, you will die. Whatever you love, is one day you are going to be separated from him. No one is going to remain with the other. No one is going to remain alive. Only the ones whom they will love Allah Almighty and Rasulullah, this love will be remaining, no separation between the one and Allah Almighty and Rasulullah. Even death cannot separate between the one and the Allah Almighty and Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. But it will be continuation for your life forever in the divine presence of Allah Almighty and Rasulullah. You will be entering in the oceans of uniqueness of Allah Almighty, in the ocean of oneness of Allah Almighty. While the one who forgot Allah Almighty, the one who put Allah Almighty on his back, never looking except how to be pleasing himself, how to be fulfilling all his desires, luxury life, happiness, only searching for this, he will be at the end biting his fingers and saying, oh, if I was in the way of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Allah Almighty was much more better for me than this way, which I choose for prosperity and luxurious life and to be fulfilling all my desires and happy in this life. All this make me to be missing Zikrullah, to forget Zikrullah Azza wa Jal, to forget to be busy by Allah Almighty and Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The companion of Rasulullah, the Sahaba, used all of them to be worshipping ideal statues far away. Even they never heard about Allah Almighty. And then Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam appearing, and by the light from his eyes coming into their hearts, into themselves, he changed their chemistry. He changed them from bad ones, non-believers, to be Sahaba, the companion of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, to be the more closest one to Allah Almighty and to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Until we say, my companion like stars, by anyone by whom he will guide himself, he will be well guided. Anyone mention the name of Sahab till day of judgment, everyone will say radiyallahu anhu anda. And anyone mention the name whom they fulfill all their desires and live luxurious life and live all the life of them to be far away from Allah Almighty and Rasulullah, like Fir'aun, like Abu Jahl, like all these whom they are only interested how to be filling their heart by proudness and controlling and ruling people, putting them under them. And any one of these people, whatever his name is mentioned, like Fir'aun, when you mention his name, they will say curse on him. When they mention the name of Abu Jahl, they will say curse on him. All people, believer or non-believer, they will say so. While the Sahaba of Rasulullah, even the non-believer, they will respect. And the believer, they say, رَضِيَ اللَّهُ عَنْهُ. And for this, we must be ones whom always, whenever we are mentioned, that Allah Almighty will be pleased from us and Rasulullah. Whenever Allah Almighty looking at our faces and our hearts, he will be pleased and Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Anyone who has even a tiniest atom of proudness and hatred and enmity in his heart, never Allah Almighty will be accepting all his worshipping or enter him to Jannah, unless he would be well clean in him in Jahannam. Then Allah Almighty, he knows what to do with him. Because Allah at the end, he is the most forgivable one and the most merciful one. But the one, even though must make as much as he can, the best to make, to please Allah Almighty and Rasulullah, and to make them happy. How they will be happy? When you will be serving the nation of Rasulullah, Rasulullah will be happy. When the one serve children of Adam alayhi salam, Allah will be happy. The one who serves the creation of Allah Almighty, Allah will be pleased and happy from him. If you are not able to serve them by your money, by your work, by anything, because you don't have this power to serve them, at least serve them by worshipping Allah Almighty on their behalf. Whatever you do, say on behalf of the nation of Rasulullah, on behalf of the all human beings, all children of Adam, of Allah Almighty. Clean your hearts, not to hate anyone, not to be enemy to anyone, not to be proud, no proudness. Make your heart not even to think, to control anyone, or to be making anyone under his command. But make everyone to be free will as Allah Almighty created him, let him be. And always see yourself, you, that we, I am the worst one, and all the people, they are the best. Sayyidina Ja'far al-Sadiq, our Imam, Sayyidina Ja'far al-Sadiq, he is a big Imam in from Ahlul Bayt al-Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and one of our man Shaykh and the Golden Shaykh, he said, always anyone do anything badness to me or do it anything, I will find for him 70 excuses to excuse him. If I don't find anything to excuse him, I will not say he is the bad, but I will say I am the bad that make him this one to go and backbite me. Like this, the awliya always looking and they ask forgiveness, not only for themselves, but they ask forgiveness for all the nation of Rasulullah. They ask forgiveness for all children of Adam alayhi salam. This how to serve the children of Adam alayhi salam. This how to serve the nation of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi salam. If you don't have power to save them by your money and by your as a physical thing, you can serve them as a spiritual thing. But don't forget to serve them. Don't forget to share them in whatever you do, in this life, in worshiping, in good deeds. Allah will make them to be shared with you, that whatever that you will do, it will be accepted by Allah Almighty. But if you worship and play and do everything on behalf of yourself alone, you are going to be questioned too much. And Allah will be cursing you and your worshiping like He cursed Satan and put victim out of paradises and Jannah. Allah is not in need for our worshiping, but when you worship on behalf of His creation, Allah will be happy because you are serving them as much as you can spiritually, because you are not able physically to help them. And the one who is able physically and spiritually to help them, like Sayyidina Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiallahu anhu, then no one can imagine what Allah Almighty will be rewarding him and upgrade him over the throne in the paradises related to Allah Almighty and to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and Sayyidina Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiallahu anhu. May Allah forgive us and mercy us. Be careful, always listen well to the advice, because this advice makes your spirituality to be upgraded and to be reaching, to be in the divine presence of Allah Almighty, in the divine presence of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Whatever is Suhbah or an advice, Maulana said and when Shaykh promising that everyone who listen and accepting, he will be blessed by all these maqams. And whatever we say about mistake or badness, they will be erased from him. And he will be clean after this rahmah, as if just now he was born. Like as if he was standing on Arafah. Because Allah Almighty, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, they will put their hands over us, because Allah Almighty saying, my almighty hand over the cloud, who meeting on Zikrullah and on advice and Suhbah. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam say also my hand over these cloud who meeting on advice and Suhbah, and they will look at them to clean them, to perfect them, to purify them, and promising to Mawlana and Grand Shaykh Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, whatever will be the advice in our meeting, all the maqams which you say, it will be addressed to them, and whatever badness, it will be erased from them. No more to be questioned when they are passing away from this life by death or in the day of judgment. Allah will forgive them. This one of the speciality which Allah Almighty and Rasulullah addressed to Grand Shaykh and Mawlana Shaykh Nasr. May Allah upgrade them and meet them in the highest maqam. And we say, إلى شرف النبي وآله وصحبه الذي أستاذنا وأستاذ الإسلام صديق اليوم الله تعالى الفاتحة.
اللهم صل على سيدنا